Hello, I am Solej Alfred. Welcome to the Hts Epoll. It's your opportunity to weigh in on the most pressing issues of the day. St. Lucia is on the cusp of another COVID-19 wave, with the number of recorded cases and deaths over the past few weeks trending upwards. The question on the minds of many is what is responsible for the recent rise in numbers? Some are pointing to the poor adherence to the COVID-19 protocols and the absence of the COVID-19 wardens to enforce the rules. So, we ask, do you think the absence of the COVID-19 wardens has contributed to the recent rise in cases? We tallied the numbers on our voting platforms and here is how you voted. 50% said yes and 50% said no. We also took to the streets to get your opinion, and here's what you had to say.
I don't think so at all, because you see, the social gathering was always taking place. Right now, it's more rampant because people saying they're fed up, you know? They're fed up, they want to socialize, they want to be among friends and families, you check, right? If you notice right now, when you go by bars, places you used to see, 6-7 people right now is 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. You check it, people don't care. No, Pamele, no.
Definitely not. It hasn't caused a high number because what the wardens used to do, they used to exercise their rights, and if they were operating under the Ministry of Health, they would be doing the job. But they wanted to be bullying people, acting like police officers. So they weren't directed properly. You understand? Better they were supervised under the Ministry of Health instead of the force. Because they were going the wrong way, bullying people and all of that. Tormenting people, where's your mask and all of that. And that's not the purpose of the job. That's not what they were on the road to do.
Well, what I believe, the people doesn't follow the protocol. Like, as they get the vaccine, they feel, well, they could go anywhere and do whatever they feel like. So they believe, well, that won't harm you at all.
Yeah, because they are not there, the cases is rising. Not because of the people right now, they're not listening to the protocol, they're not putting masks, nothing so. You understand? COVID
cases? No, I don't believe so. COVID or not, Lucians just don't care, they don't follow protocol. So the wardens or not, the case will still go up, it will still go up down. So we just need to do what we have to do for the protocols and the cases will get back to normal. But the wardens not stopping the cases from going up.
No, I don't think so. Solutions are just frustrated, they're tired of being indoors, so they're just doing things anyhow, and they're not following the protocol.
Thanks for those responses. Now to our new discussion. The government of St. Lucia has declared Monday, 24th May, Whitsuntide holiday, as a day of fasting and prayer. The idea is to seek divine intervention for some of the many problems that confront St. Lucia. The event, which will be broadcast on television and radio stations, will feature church services, gospel performances, prayer, spoken word, and testimonies. So, we ask, do you expect something positive to come out of the day of fasting and praying? Voting is easy. Just log on to htsstlucia.org or Facebook at HTS St. Lucia Official and vote. You can also send your response via text or WhatsApp to 584 for HTS. That's 584-4487. For Flow handset owners, here's a reminder of your special voting platform. From your Flow handset, text your Epoll response to 487. Press 1 to vote yes, 2 for no, 3 no comment, and 4 I don't know. Join the discussion from your Flow device and get the opportunity to win weekly prizes. And our Epoll team is always on the go to get your responses as well. Watch the HTS News Force from 7 p.m. for the results and a new discussion.